What's going on, guys? It's SpinoDude here, and you're looking at my monitor right now because we're going to be doing a collection update video today, which I should do more often when I change my collection and display around, but I just never get around to it. But yeah, I just want to plug this video again right here, the PNSO SE and the Spinosaurus review. I put a lot of hard work into that, so if you guys could check that out, I'd really appreciate it. That's the first video of my masterclass reviews. But anyway, just on my desk here, we just have some Funko Pops there. We have Dilophosaurus, Ian Malcolm from Jurassic Park, Genji from Overwatch, my Papocompsognathus with my Peabody Museum of Natural History mug with an Ichthyornis on it, and my little air plant there as well, which is pretty nifty. But anyway, I'm going to move over to my main shelves now so we can take a look at those. Before we move over to the main shelves, here is my nightstand with the Vitae Giganotosaurus resting on top. Also, guys, if you hear my AC unit, I'm sorry, but it has to be on right now. It is ridiculously hot in my room right now. It's like 100 degrees over in New England right now. But anyway, there is a Vitae Giganotosaurus leaning on a guitar slide, and that is a real feather. That is an osprey feather that I found while hiking last week. Let's move to my shelves now. Alrighty, guys, so here are the main shelves right here. They've changed a little bit with the addition of some new figures, and they're going to be changing more coming up. But on the top, we have Papo. I don't think there's any new figures up here. I did do this, which I'm quite proud of. That is the Caprosuchus chomping on the Pteranodon's leg there, which I thought was pretty cool, and he's just leaning on the Baryonyx. But yeah, nothing too much has changed. We have the Apatosaurus over on the top there, and yeah, that's it. We haven't gotten any new Papa figures, but moving down to the Safari shelf, this is where things start to get a little interesting. I've changed it around quite a bit here, a substantial amount. For new additions, we have the beautiful Allosaurus right there. One of my all-time favorite Safari figures now. Absolutely adore that figure. We still have the frog riding on the T-Rex's head there, which is great. I put the Anzu and the Cassowary and the Citipati together because they all look so similar and bird-like. Like, looking at these, the most prehistoric looking of all of these actually is the Cassowary itself, which is pretty crazy. That's my opinion, though. We have the new Stegosaurus here, a pretty nice figure. We have the Pteranodon and Bernie the Gator just chilling right there as well. There's the Carnotaurus. The Giganotosaurus, another one of my all-time favorite Safari figures. Absolutely gorgeous piece. Coelophysis, another one of my all-time favorites. My favorite 2017 figure, actually, with the little Good Luck Minis chicken. There's the Styracosaurus from 2019. My Ceratopsians with the Triceratops and the Inosaurus at the top. Camarasaurus in the back there, just chilling. Pretty cool. And I have the Amargosaurus on the top in the center. Of course, like, I have the sauropods, the three big sauropods going along the back there, and then I have the Malawisaurus just chilling over here, which I thought was pretty cool. That's my Safari shelf. Moving down to everything else, and also extended Safari shelf. So here, actually, here's Ivory from Titans of Acralis. Just chilling there because I have nowhere else to put her. But here's my favorite Cenozoic figures. Not all of the figures I own are on display right now, just because I want to try to keep things looking a little more orderly, but I'm going to need to thin them out again on the shelves a bit. But this is the Kronosaurus and the Tylosaurus. Another two of my favorite Safari figures, with the Plesiosuchus. There's the retired Gastornis. Moving on to some Carnegie stuff here, we have the Carnegie, whoopsie, the Ichthyosaurus, which is a great figure. We have the new Carnegie, not new, but I recently acquired it from Kayakosaurus, the Carithosaurus, which is a gorgeous little figure. Into my Schleich stuff now, which we have the Dunkelosteus out front, the beautiful Psittacosaurus and the Kentrosaurus. There is the PNSO Confuciusormis, which Kayakosaurus also sent over. And then into Collecte, which is at the very end here, and we have the brand new Edaphosaurus. I recently got the Stegosaurus corpse there, which has the Torbosaurus looming over it, and the Borulopelta, which is another new addition there, as you can see. Yeah, and I have the Dunkelosteus as well, which Kikizilla 101 got me for my birthday, which was awesome. So thank you, Maine. Actually, let me pull you out. There you go. Right there. Yeah, the two dunks look pretty cool with each other, so that's that. And then down here, we just have this little area where I have some painted models. There's a couple of my prey collection pieces. It's a little dusty down here. My Mattel figures as well that I currently, that I still have. There's the Indoraptor with my tickets to Fallen Kingdom. There is a Jurassic World Barbasol can back there. The Albertosaurus. My couple of my painted minis, the Mosasaurus, the Indominus Rex, and such. Yeah, and there's Blue, the Baryonyx, one of my all-time favorites, and there's Monarch, the Torosaurus. And then this is where I store some of my stuff that I don't have places to display yet, so there's some repainted figures in there, there's my dioramas I've made, I've got to make room for those somewhere. Here is my figures that are currently not on display, like Safari Uteranus, I just couldn't find a place to put him with the new ones on display. There are, here's the Safari Allosaurus, which is one I have to review coming up. But that's where I put ones that are kind of archived, but ones that I want to keep. And then on the bottom, we just have like painting supplies and other stuff like that, which is cool. But that's my cart. But let's move on to my final and probably my favorite part of my collection where I display stuff. And here it is, ladies and gentlemen. This is my Spinosaurus shelf right here, and I'm pretty happy with this. Here we have the recently reviewed pride of my collection. I love this thing so, so much. There's SE and the Spinosaurus from PNSO. There's my repainted Collecte Swimming Spino, Neda the Little Spinosaurus, Carnegie Spinosaurus, Schleich Spinosaurus, which I'm kind of sad I spent money on it now. It's really just not a pretty figure, but there's the Safari Spinosaurus, the Papo Juvenile Spino, the Juvenile Safari Spino, the old one, and the Papo Spino. As well as Fallen Kingdom on DVD back there, and my Ultimate Guide to Jurassic Park from Entertainment Weekly that I got. But that's it, guys. That's the entirety of my collection right there. There's my main shelves there, and then there's my Spinosaurus shelf. But let me know what's your favorite part, and I'll try to do these videos more often, but my favorite part is just this part of this shelf with this masterpiece right here. I'm going to be getting more PNSO statues in the future, so make sure you stay around for more masterclass reviews. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video, so take care, and bye-bye.